Now, if the distinct elements of A are mapped into distinct elements of B, then a function from A to B is what? So now, distinct elements of A. So all the elements of A are distinct. So for example, we will have A, B, C. And the elements of B which are distinct are 1, 2, 3. So we are considering this for example. Now these distinct elements are mapped into distinct elements of B. So A is mapped to 1. Now B cannot be mapped to 1 because the elements of B are also, they are mapped to distinct elements. So it should be mapped to some other element. And C cannot be mapped to 1 and 2. And so C has to be mapped to a distinct element 3. So when we have a mapping of this kind, it is called a 1-to-1 function. So the function is said to be a 1-to-1 function. So this is the answer. The next question is, the relation less than is what? So options are given here. Reflexive, transitive, symmetric, equivalence. So this less than relation is what we have to check out. Now for example, we will have A less than B. So we are having two elements. Now we have the symbol lesser than. Now we have to check whether it is reflexive, transitive, symmetric or equivalence. So reflexive means A has to be lesser than A itself. But this is not possible because an element cannot be lesser than itself. So it is not reflexive. So this is not reflexive. The next one, it has to be. The next one is it cannot be symmetric also because A lesser than B does not imply B is lesser than A. Because when a number is lesser than another number, then the other number cannot be lesser than this. For example, if 3 is lesser than 5, definitely 5 is not lesser than 3. So this is not symmetric also. But the correct answer is it is transitive because if we have three numbers, for example, if A is lesser than B and B is lesser than C, then we can say that now because A is lesser than B and B is lesser than C, we can say that A is lesser than C. So it is transitive. Therefore, the relation less than is transitive. So this is the correct option. Now, the next question is, a function f from A to B is called a dash if every element of A has the same image in B. For example, we will consider two sets A and B and let the elements of A be 1, 2, 3 and let the elements of the set B be A, B, C. Now, if every element of A, has the same image in B. For example, if they have the same image here, like this. So if they have the same image, then what is that function? That function is known as a constant function. And so the answer is constant function. So it is called a constant function. Okay. Now here in this next question, they have given a set A and a set B and they have given the mapping here. Now they are asking, what is this? Is this a function or is it a 1-to-1 function or is it not a function or onto function? They have given four options. So now we shall check this. So for that, let us draw the set A and the set B. So list out the elements of the set A. They are minus 2, 0, 3, 4. And then the elements of B are 5, 7, 9. Now let us give the mapping. So minus 2 is mapped to 9. So here is the mapping. 0 to 5. So like this. 2 to 5. So there is no element 2 here. And then 4 is mapped to 7. So this is the mapping. But if you see here in this set, the element 3 is not having a mapping at all. So if any element is left out in the domain, so this is our domain and this is our codomain. If any element is left out in the domain without any mapping, then it cannot be a function at all. So this is not a function is the right option. Now here in this question, they have given if f of x is equal to x plus 1 by x, they are asking us to find what is f of x equal to out of these options. So first now we shall check what is this. So f of minus x will be equal to, so in this place you have to change it by negative x. So you will get minus x and this will also be minus x. So it will be minus 1 by x. So now if you see the f of x is not equal to this. So this is not the right option. So now next we will move on to this. So f of, we will find what is f of minus 1 by x. So when we substitute minus 1 by x, it will become minus 1 by x minus, when you have 1 by x here, that x will go to the numerator and it will become minus x. Again, f of x is not equal to this. So this is also not the right option. Similarly, f of x plus 1, okay, this one will be equal to x plus 1 plus 1 by x plus 1. So we are substituting here instead of x, we are writing it as x plus 1. But if we find that again, this is also not equal to f of x, so it is also not the right option. Whereas the last option, so we have f of 1 by x to be equal to, now instead of x, if we put 1 by x, now here we will get 1 by x plus 1 by 1 by x. So instead of x, we have to put 1 by x. Now this x will go to the numerator and it becomes 1 by x plus x. So therefore, it is x plus 1 by x which is equal to f of x. So this and this are equal. Therefore, f of x is equal to f of 1 by x. So this is the right answer. Hope you understood all the problems. Thank you.